Breaking news in the nationwide Amber Alert for a missing Fayetteville girl. Good afternoon from the Raleigh Eyewitness News Center. I'm Barbara Gibbs.
And I'm John Clark. Within this past hour, Fayetteville police updated us on their search for 5-year-old Shaniya Davis. The man who they believed had the little girl is now in custody, but Shaniya is still missing. Police arrested Mario McNeil overnight. He was spotted on surveillance video Tuesday morning carrying the child at a hotel in Sanford. We have team coverage beginning with John Camp live at the Fayetteville Police Department with the breaking details. John?
Well, good afternoon. First and foremost, we should say that police say that the little girl, Shaniya Davis, is still missing. But as you said just an hour ago, we learned that they have made another arrest in connection with this case. Mario McNeil, they arrested him overnight, interrogated him through the night, and just this morning charged him with first-degree kidnapping. Now, this is surveillance video taken just Tuesday morning, just after 6 a.m. at a Sanford motel. You can see 5-year-old Shaniya Davis being carried by McNeil. Police say she was taken from her home here in Fayetteville that morning. They found her blanket in a neighbor's trash can. Again, police not saying if they know where Shaniya is at this hour or if she's alive, only saying that their investigation continues.
We are following up. We're receiving new leads all the time. Again, since that footage was aired last night, we've received a lot of phone calls. Every single phone call has to be followed up on. So again, we continue to follow up on all leads and tips that we have.
Now, Clarence Coe, who had been arrested in connection with this case earlier, is being released today. In his place, Mario McNeil, under arrest, being held on a $100,000 secured bond. He'll be in court today at 2:30. So will we. John.
All right, John Camp, live at the Fayetteville Police Department. Thank you.
Now, police got a break in the search for Shaniya from a worker at a Sanford hotel who called authorities after spotting the little girl with Mario McNeil. Tamara Gibbs continues our breaking news coverage. She's live at the Comfort Suites on Bragg Street in Sanford with the latest from there. Tamara?
Hi, Barbara. This is the last place little Shaniya was seen, caught on surveillance video inside this hotel. We're told that was around early Tuesday morning, shortly before her mother reported her missing. Now, we're also told that in this video, she appeared to look unharmed. She appeared okay. That image was captured outside the hotel elevator, but as you know, her whereabouts after this are unknown. A hotel worker reported her missing, but by the time authorities arrived here at the hotel, McNeil had already checked out. The hotel has declined to comment except to say that it works closely with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, and it distributes Amber Alert information to its hotels whenever there's a missing child. Meantime, Shaniya's father recently made a desperate plea for his daughter's safe return.
We all miss her and love her very much. Contact the police department. Anybody who has any information, whoever has children out there knows how much their child means to them. Allow them to bring her home safely to us. Shaniya, if you're listening to Daddy, I miss you so much, honey, and I'm waiting for you. I'm not going to give up, and you don't give up either, honey.
Well, obviously an emotional plea from little Shaniya's father, and again, no sign of her whereabouts. This could possibly be the strongest lead that investigators have when she was caught on surveillance video inside this hotel. We can't emphasize it enough, Barbara. Anyone with information about this little girl should give local authorities a call.
All right, thank you, Tamara Gibbs, live in Sanford this noon. And stay with Eyewitness News throughout the day for more updates as they happen. You can get the latest online at abc11.com. You can also get updates on Twitter and on the Eyewitness News Facebook page.